have a very special guest. It's the 031 Chopper himself from the 031 in Durban. Chopper, what's going on, man?
I'm feeling it.
Nigga in the industry, 031 Chopper, my guy.
You are producing.
Bro,
videographing
visuals back to back. Dog, visuals every 2 weeks. Bro, the consistency keeps dropping.
Al-Katal.
I can't be comfortable, dog. Like, I'm from far, dog. Like, Guamashi, dog. I'm from Guamashi, dog.
You're so hungry for it.
Like, I'm too hungry, dog. I can't be chilling, dog. And, like, it's not like that I have like rich parents that wanna give me money. I have to get all the cash like by myself. So I need to spend, though. I can't be resting, though.
Too much.
But Chopper, I feel like you're aiming for something. Rest, if you never rest, you rust, man. Big fact. But I feel like you're reaching for something. You're kitchy, and now you're running. I don't know if whether there's something you're trying to gain before time's up, or it's just the fact that, yo, me, I have to get up now. I have to hit my 9-to-5 and do my best.
Dog, I need an award, dog. Like, I can't be a musician and you don't have an award, dog. Like, I need to get my own crib, my own car, fancy car. You see? So, and like, I'm still young. I know I look old. I'm like, I'm only 23, dog. I read like mentality.
I'm
26. I'm young,
dog. I'm young, dog. So, like, I told myself, yo, dog, I'm trying to get all that, like, before I'm 25, dog. But I have 25. I need to have my own awards. I need to have my own crib, my own cars, dog. I need to, like, to be living my best life. So that's why I'm working like this right now. And, like, dog, like, I'm not from here, dog. I wanna, like,
The audience must know. The audience must know, Pele.
Like 650k away, dog, from here. Like that. Like, we're for Span, dog.
How did you feel growing up there and then deciding, yo, I need to. When did you realize that, yo, I need to actually go to Jersey to push my music?
It's a sad story. I was on drugs heavy, dog. And when I finished my matric in 2015, I just wanted like something within my leg. So I moved in with my homie from Durban. He used to work this side in Jersey. And he told me, yo, I'm going back to Jersey tomorrow because I'm working this side. I'm like, ish, where you stay? Like, I stayed a 2-bedroom flat alone. I'm like, yo, can I actually come to Jersey with you?
Spine.
And the time my mom doesn't travel for that shit, he's like, yeah, sure, dog, you can like sleep on the area. We drove with this car the next morning, like 4 a.m. We're ready. We got this started like on my 12th, during the day. That's when I called my mom, like, yo, I'm in Jersey, dog. And she's like, what the fuck? What are you doing? Like, funala. I'm like, ah, dog. I'm here to look for Span, because like, she wouldn't like, I wasn't doing, like, can I tell you something? The music, I started doing it, like, 2016 when I got to Joburg. In Durban, I wasn't doing the music shit.
Nothing.
So, I was like, ah, I'm here to look for Span. And then, like, I got the Span. I used to work at Cambridge. You know, I was a promoter there. This guy, Mr. Kumba Kumba. I used to be that character. I used to work as that character at Cambridge, dog. I used to promote with the mic there and stuff.
Yeah.
And then, well, my June 2016, that's when I met up with my bro from the other bro from Durban. He's a young kid. He was 12 years old. He was a producer because he lived with his parents.
Yeah.
Like the parents are singers. Like Sarafina days. They used to do those things.
What is his name?
Fiji Makeba.
Fiji Makeba.
Yeah. Huh? Like you must check him out on Instagram, bro. He's gonna drop some crazy music soon.
Heck.
Fiji Makeba. So and then I started staying with him because I saw he had a studio and I really fucked with the music, dog. So I was like, yo, I actually wanna like learn this thing and actually do it now, because like I wasn't enjoying the Span I was doing at Cambridge. And then I stayed with the guy, Fiji, because I know his mom. I know them from Durban as well. So it was like, they like, come stay with us. And then I used to be there in the studio every day, trying to figure out how to make beats. So every time he's at Scala, me, I'll be chilling there, trying to make a beat. And then when he comes back, he's gonna tell me, yo, this sounds crazy, like, and so, yeah. And then That's when I met, like, my 2017, that's when I met guys like Zeus, because he was telling me, ah, Zeus is going to put you on and shit like that.
But where's your speeches?
Zeus Omega.
Zeus. Yeah. Yeah, they stay in the same hood in the south. Yeah, they stay in the same hood. And they grew up together, so he's like, ah, God, my name is Zeus. Like, just speak to him, bro. He's going to advise you when it comes to the music shit. Then, like, yeah, that's when I met Zeus, and then I started becoming spaces like Ngea in Dawene, Paya. And that's when I got to like have a lot of people. I think when we were 2019.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I got a job with Crocs after. I was selling Crocs. I don't know if you guys
know.
I used to wear Crocs a lot, dog, back in the days. If you can just go to my old.
I'm at 2000s, don't know what Crocs are, fella.
Yeah, I used to wear a lot of Crocs. So after Crocs, that's when like, because I was like making a lot of beats and sending them to Zeus every day. I was making like 10 beats every day, sending them to Zeus. Yo, dog, find me someone to jam on his beats. Yeah, well. And then I was like, are you actually too much to producing? Then they got me a job, sports in when the studio opened.
What year?
In 2019. Okay. Like, I was the first guy who worked there at the studio, like the first producer.
Oh, shout out to Sportsy.
Already, you're doing a lot, and that's like 4 years after me three.
Then I got a job here at Sportsy, and bro, this place right here, the studio was still that size.
Back
like,
there.
This setup the table was still that side, the mic was this side.
So,
it was crazy. That's when I literally met everyone in the game. Like, Ricky came here, literally everyone. Lucas, Costa, Teach, now I produce for Costa, like, everyone. I met them here in this studio, dog.
Yo, this is like your home.
Yeah. How was it meeting Bozong, Ricky?
Oh, it was crazy, dog. Like, I was even, like, late, dog. I wasn't late. So I went out to go.
Take a spliff.
Yeah, when I came back, I just sent them a shout. Dog, where the fuck were you, dog? And I can see, oh, Rick is waiting for me. I'm like, yeah. Away. I could see him from there. I'm like, oh, so Rick is waiting for me. I came in, good vibes. I started like making beats.
But Rick,
like,
I got shot.
Nah, it was actually chill, dog. But like me, I was so scared, bro, because I was yo, why is everything happening so fast, dog? Hey, now I'm here with Rick, and I was like, yo, I'm gonna make a beat, dog.
One by one.
And so I'm like, okay, like, I was so scared, bro. I don't wanna lie, dog. I made one beat, we vibed with it, and he's like, let's just keep it South African, bro. And then we made another beat, I jumped on it ASAP. Like, we still have the song here in this computer, dog. He hasn't dropped.
Aye.
Yeah, Ricky.
Can you find that one?
Ricky, drop that one.
And drop it on the piano.
Absolutely, Ricky, drop.
I think I'm gonna drop that. I think I'm gonna drop that one maybe this year.
So what is that, like a collab between you and Ricky, or is it just?
Yeah, it's just me and Ricky. I'm trying to get Foka or Dalez on the song.
Okay.
I'm just waiting for the verses, and then we're gonna rock off there.
So who else besides Ricky? Because you said you had a couple of people come in here. Costa,
Costa, I'm working with him, like all here? The like literally all the new wave guys that you know, they were like popping when I came to Jose, like all those new wave cats.
What's your opinion on Marcus Harvey?
Yo, Marcus is hard, boy.
Because there was a time when you started popping.
Marcus
Harvey was popping.
So I met Marcus here. He came, like, he was looking for me, was DMing me, and me, I was just seeing a guy from Cars. I'm like, fuck this guy. Why is this guy always DMing me, dog?
Yeah.
Oh, and then he came here with Sam After Life. He's a photographer. He came here. I was working here. He came with this guy. He's also like, why are you bringing people here? Yeah, dog. And Marcus played one song, dog. And then the guys are like, wait, what the fuck is going on there, dog? Yeah. And he kept on playing songs, dog. Yeah. And we like, yo, who's this guy, dog? I can see him, like, dog, Shang and Jamie, Asika, Asitana, Alex, dog. We're like, yo. Yeah, that's when I met Marcus, and then we started working on this project with my boy Fiji Makeba.
Yeah.
Like if you can go to Marcus's, like, go check the song that I produced by Fiji. That's the guy that told me how to produce. He was 12 years old, and I was 17 or 16.
Fiji, man.
He stays in the south. Like, dog, he's gonna drop some music right now.
I think he's gonna come like, here and actually, to rock.
He's actually, he's in the south.
Okay. How is things back? Now, I mean, like, as in, like, now. Akai, that side.
I haven't been there in a minute, bro. It's tough.
So everyone's, like, watching you from that side?
Yeah, I haven't been there, like, since it's been a year now.
Mara bakufonele, they do check up.
But like, why don't you vibe back home, dog? And just check, hey, what means I got land in
dog,
too much fun, yeah, no time.
COVID, also. Dog. Obviously, when you in Joburg, dog, when you go back at home, you need to come back like a man, bro. It needs to make sense, because you can't be gone for a long time and then you want to come back the same day. Like, you're going to be asking your mom for food and shit like that. You need to come back as like a man when you come back, bro. It's like, that's like our rule, like us Zulu niggas, dog. Like, bro, if you out to hustle, dog, you need to, when you come back, like, she needs to make sense, dog. You can't be gone and then when you come back, you don't have anything, dog. And that's why I'm pushing so hard, cause like I need to make like shit happen, dog.
But you are pushing and making things happen. What advice would you give to the youngins, the guys that are at the, we all know them. There are guys that are trying to scratch the surface
on the come up.
That are starting to catch attention now. I'm not talking about
because you're one there now, but you can clearly see when are you you're getting to your position now.
Nah, bro, this thing, bro, it's either you do it or you don't. So, because like me, when I resigned at work, I chose with your fuck this thing. I'd rather not have money for rent. I'd rather like say, okay, now I'm making a living out of selling beats. Though you need to like commit to this shit, bro. You need to put your heart into this shit. Cause like, if you wanna do it as your hobby, bro, I'm sorry, that it's not gonna happen. So you need to like you need to be about this shit, dog. Like, you need to actually like move away saying dog, music, dog, like ula,
heart
like,
and
dog.
Soul.
Yeah, it needs to be like a shit like something that you do every day, dog. Yeah.
But like one thing that I have with artists, the problem that I have with artists, like you saying to me, yo, space, you have to be in the studio, you have to eat, sleep, breathe, go to the toilet go to the toilet music. Every single minute of every single thing,
the routine
is music. But there comes a point where being in the studio every single day of the week, locked in the studio, doesn't help.
Nah, you see the problem is that niggas don't drop music, dog. Make the song, drop it. If it's hard, you feel like it's doing too much, drop a music video, make the song, drop it. But you can't be making music every day. That's why I mean, like, I'm a producer. Sometimes I make beats. Sometimes I'm just mixing and mastering.
Sometimes you just rap.
Yeah.
See,
yeah, bro.
Shit.
Yo. See, like, dog, cause like I have clients, dog. I make beats for people, like I mix and master for people. So like, it's not like I'm just like maybe on the mic every day. Like I do anything that has to do with music, like almost every day, dog.
Yeah.
I hope a whole lot of you guys have heard this. I'm always one person to say,
sit
yo,
in studio.
Bro, I get a lot of people that tell me like, yo, space. I've been working, dog. I'm working hard, bro. Like, yo, dog, I'm working.
But I waited
for the music.
Yeah, and I'm like, okay, you working.
Where are the hit songs?
Yeah, what were you doing? Like, where are you working? What did you do?
Like, they said, like, they got a 9-to-5.
Hey, dog, like, I'm like, yo, let's listen to the music. Let's see your process. Like, are you building a fan base? Like, type of, like.
Are you taking our content?
Yeah, like.
Are you showing the world who you are?
Yeah. Do you think that music is 10% of what you should be actually doing to push yourself into the music industry?
Or do you feel like it's more entertainment and more, like.
Yo, bro, like, you must be a full package, dog.
Facts.
Like. Dog, you must be a full package, dog.
It goes back to putting on.
Like, dog, like your image, like, dog, your brand, dog, must make sense, dog. It must align you to the music you do, dog. You see? And, like, the business side, dog, as well, it needs to make sense, dog. Because, like, you can't be saying I'm in school, you're working every day, but, like, dog, we need to eat, dog. So, what is the music doing for you, dog? What are you doing to put, like, food on the table with the music shit that you do? So, like, dog, you must be, like, a full package, dog. The image. And then, like, the music needs to make sense as well, bro. Like, it needs to slap, dog. It needs to slap, dog, unfortunately, dog. You can work every day, but if the music is bad, it's bad.
wait, can I ask a quick question? How do you tell your friends or your customers, whoever they are, like, if the music is bad, how do you tell them?
Do you
stay straight or...
Dog, either. You see, if a nigga just plays a song, I don't dance at all. I just get angry.
Yo, but I've done that a lot of times. I've kept quiet, I've chilled, and I'm just like this. And I'm like, yeah, it's
God?
But some people
like
bump
I just
it.
Shut the fuck up, bro. And just like, acts angry, dog, and like something is bothering me, then you tell your song is bad, then. But if I'm feeling it, I'm gonna tell you, ah, fuck this shit up. But like, if it's bad, dog, yo, I lose my mind, dog. Like, like shine in Baba Mara. I'm holding myself. You can see this bro wants to move you, but.
No, but the thing is, some artists get in the studio and they think, yo, this is fire, bro. Like, are you listening to this? For me, like, as you say, keeping quiet. And even if you look at him, you're like,
angry, dog.
When's Ani?
Because, like, niggas get too touched when you tell them, dog. Like, ish.
They think you hating.
Yeah, they think you hating. Like, so, yeah. Like, yo, me, I just like.
Honestly, it's hard when you're being honest with some people and then they think you're hating. What do you do next?
Ish, dog, right, now
and then they say you must promote my music, and it's like,
you
huh.
See? Right, dog. And like me, like, bro, you see those kids that pull up and saying, oh, promote my music? Me, I slut bomb, because, like, I don't want to say shit. That's why I'm not even on Twitter. Because, like, ish, dog, me, dog. I'm an angry Zulu guy, dog. Like.
You're
too hard. So but eventually, not to say anything. Like, I'm too long to show next. Cause like, if I talk, dog, now it's.
But don't you think eventually you're gonna have to be on Twitter? Nah. Cause I had to get Twitter.
I am on Twitter, but I don't say shit. I only get there and promote. If I drop something, I get there and promote out. I don't care what's happening there, or what's trending. I don't care.
Oh, wait. Black
Twitter. Who's the wackest guy in the industry right now that you can say, yo, long cheat the music, yah, can you boo me? The fuck.
Do you ever say? You're not the outlay,
you can just stop making.
Like, he's
music.
Dropping, he has clout, Mara is dropping bombs.
And it's hectic, guys, yo.
It's no one, I just think it's Chopper doesn't want to listen to crap music.
It's hectic. It's just that me, I only listen to hard shit, dog.
Exactly.
So I don't know who's back, dog. Like, I don't even get there, dog. Yeah, dog.
Okay, but who can you say that is one of your favorite artists that, yo, I've worked with? Work, this guy, yeah. Yo, I don't know. I've worked with him, or you still want to work with him? Who can you say is that one artist in South Africa?
It's Anati is going to drop a project now. I have like.
Oh, where's Anati? Yo,
I produced like one or two songs there. And, like,
yo, Anati's coming back.
Yeah,
for real. Goddamn!
You know, Loki. Back in the day, when you first came out, Loki thought you were Anati's young cousin. I'm like, hey, young Anati, pull it up. Then I found O31 Chop. I'm like, okay, fair.
Yeah, like I produced like one or two songs. I don't know. I gave him like a few beats, but he recorded like two. I'm gonna put them on his album. Like, that's the guy I've been like meaning to work with, and it's Java, dog. It's my bro. I met him like a few days ago, bro. I was with Zuchi and Speedstar. I was literally sleeping in the couch, dog. Dog, 3 a.m, bro. This guy is waking me up. Hey, Nkavi. Dog, I thought that guy is there to kill me or something. Like, Shabufuna, like, dog, like that. Like, bro, it was so scary, dog. Yeah. That's how I met Shabu.
What?
Dog.
In
3 a.m.? Like, 3 a.m, bro. Just imagine to 3 a.m, you've been woken up by Shabu.
Begafuna, at 3 a.m, man.
Nkavufuna. Like, this guy is there to kill me or what? Nah, he came with Speedstar, dog. Yeah, on Strava, dog. I produce for Strava, but like I actually wanna be with him on the song, dog.
Yeah,
him and Anati. Yeah.
So Chief, when are you dropped User Now with Dico Ale and Blacky?
Black, yeah.
How did you feel when you dropped the music video?
Nah, I felt so great, dog, cause like I feel like that's like the best music video right now in SA hip hop scene, dog. I don't feel like there's any music video that's gonna touch them right now.
Who shot it?
Tia Lenzo.
Got one of the best behind the scenes.
Yeah. Shout out Lenzo.
And then, so now it seems like, because you've been dropping a couple of songs along the way, and you're a producer/artist.
Yeah.
Are you going to be dropping your own project as an artist, or are you going to be dropping a project for other, you know, produce for artists type of thing?
You know, like, I don't really like talking about stuff, but like, just started, like, just like music coming, bro.
It's coming along.
Yeah. Like, I haven't really planned everything now, but like, there's like gang music that's kind of this on the way, dog.
Trust. Spacey.
Shout out for every single person that was watching the show. It's your boy, Spacey's leader from Fresh and Meg. You know the vibes. Today we had O31 Chopper in the building. And we
are out. Season 2.